Le verbe faillir. Okay, so we can start right now. And basically, it's quite interesting because faillir is quite useful. It's a strange verb. You will see that in this lesson, but it is used quite much. And the meaning of faillir is almost do something or all but do something. Okay, so the important thing that you get to keep in mind is that it is mostly used at the passé composé form, okay? On l'utilise principalement au passé composé. Alright, but then, as we want to cover fully this verb, we'll see la conjugaison, and then we'll see the present form as well, because, well, you'll see there is a good reason for that. So, faillir, alright, at the present form, and it goes like, je faut, tu faut, il faut, elle faut, nous faillons, vous faillez, il faille, elle faille. Okay? And before continuing, let's admit that it is really rare to hear or to see these forms. Okay? But then, they do exist. So that's the reason why I thought it was important to show these forms to you. So one more time, it goes like je faut. Okay, remember. X, but then you don't pronounce it. Tu faut, il faut, elle faut. Then, nous faillons, vous faillez, il faille, elle faille. Alright? Okay? And if you look carefully, then you will notice that there is something quite strange here, because here you've got a form that normally you should already know, and it's actually the verb falloir, to have to. So remember, because falloir, it's what we call impersonnel, you get only this il form, okay? But it's quite interesting because it is exactly the same form, okay? But then when normally you encounter in a text il faut, then it's in most of the cases it will be connected to falloir, okay? But keep that in mind. It might be connected with faillir even if we don't use the present form that often. Okay? And then let's see now faillir and the passé composé form. J'ai failli. Tu as failli. Il a failli. Elle a failli. Nous avons failli. Vous avez failli. Ils ont failli, elles ont failli. All right, so these forms are actually the most used. All right, so one more time. J'ai failli, okay, so you can see that you use avoir, okay, like most of the verbs, and then participe passé, failli. Tu as failli, il a failli, elle a failli. Nous avons failli, remember, little liaison here. Vous avez failli, same thing. Ils ont failli, elles ont failli. So let's see now few examples. Faillir, faire quelque chose. So basically, as we saw, it's almost do something. Avoir failli, faire quelque chose. So it will be actually what you would use if you put that at the passé composé form. Alright, so it will go like j'ai failli avoir une amende. I almost had a fine. Okay, so you can see here that it's actually this passé composé form that we just encountered a few seconds or minutes ago. J'ai failli avoir une amende. Okay, then the second example, tu as failli avoir un accident. Exactly the same concept. You almost had an accident. Okay. Tu as failli avoir un accident. And the last example, elle a failli avoir des problèmes. She almost got into troubles. Okay? Elle a failli avoir des problèmes. So in these cases, basically you will use, you know, faillir here and you continue with avoir something. Okay? Tu as failli avoir un accident. Elle a failli avoir des problèmes. And it's quite useful. I mean, we don't use that maybe all the time, but it's not rare when we use this expression and this verb faillir. Okay? A few examples. J'ai failli tomber. I almost fell. Okay? So in that case, you just see that we use the verb faillir at the passé composé form, and then we just put in verb at the infinitive right after. J'ai failli tomber. Tu as failli partir. You almost left. Tu as failli partir. Elle a failli se tromper. She almost made a mistake. Elle a failli se tromper. So it's actually quite simple, as you see. Just put faillir at the passé composé form and put a verb at the infinitive after. J'ai failli tomber. Tu as failli partir. Elle a failli se tromper.